In the last part, we discuss that is the development of male gametophyte. In this topic, we discuss that is the development of female gametophyte. So, it is the process with the help of this diagram, you can easily understand the what is the exact steps are involved in the development of female gametophyte. It is a nothing but a megasporogenesis. Microsporogenesis and another process is megasporogenesis. In the megasporogenesis, the diploid megaspores or megaspore, in case of it is the process formation of haploid megaspores to or from diploid megaspores. So it is called as megasporogenesis. It is the process in which formation of haploid megaspores to or from diploid megaspores. And who are the responsible for this? That is, megaspore mother cell is responsible for this divination, and here is the conversion of four haploid megaspores. It is a diagram of a four haploid megaspores. In this case, meiosis get formed, or because of meiosis, this process can be easily done. So here, when there is a four haploid megasporosis get formed, actual the development of female gametophyte process get start. Here the meiosis takes place, and when there are megaspores are in the form of these haploid structure or arranged one by one, in that case the upper three megaspores get degenerated, or we called as a degenerated cells. That upper three megaspores are get degenerated, or upper three megaspores get abort. We called as a easy word, that is a aborted. After that, the growth is nourished, or growth is converted by a new cellus, or growth is nourished by new cellus, and when it goes on a functional, or it goes on a functional stage. So it acts as only a one cell of megaspore. Here three get diminished or three get abort, so one get for a growth, or that one remains part of that megaspore get nourished with the help of by new cellus, and here the only one can be developed later on. From 2 to get 4, and after 4 3 get diminished, only single is remains. After that, single get nourished, and single is from a growth stage. It is in fact the first cell of, we called as, this is the first cell of female gametophyte or female gametophyte. It undergoes, there are three successive free nuclear mitotic division takes place. It goes nearest goes on a micropyle, and there are mitosis takes place. Thus, that mitotic division takes place. Here is the first mitotic division, and here is the second mitotic division. When these growth nourished nucleus is get converted into four nucleus, so there are two mitotic divisions can be takes place, or two times mitosis can be takes place, and one nucleus from each pole migrate towards the center of the nucleus. After that, first stage get complete, second stage get complete, another, there are four nucleus get present, and here the third mitosis takes place. And what happen after that three mitosis processes? The there are two polar nuclei, or at the center point there are two nucleus are get located. We called as the name of that two nucleus is called as polar nuclei. Again, at their two ends there are two synergids are present, and on the upper side there are three antipodal cells are present. So this is again the egg apparatus, or in between there are two synergids. There is a egg is present. It is a consist of a, it's a central haploid egg cells with a two supporting two synergids. A synergid shows hair like a projections on there. For this there are two here that two synergids are having a hair like projection for a, because of the protection of that a particular egg cell, called as that hair like projection is called as filiform apparatus, which guide the pollen to the, or which guide the pollen to the, towards the egg. There are three antipodal cells are present at the chalazal end. We call as this end is nothing but a chalazal end. In case of anatomous ovule, we see the upper end, we called as a, in last lecture we studied the chalaza, that is the upper end of the micropyle, it is the opposite end of the micropyle. So at a chalazal end there are three antipodal cells are there, and in that there is a nuclear fusion takes place, and the nuclear secondary nuclear fusion takes place and it forms a mature embryo sac, or these seven cell and eight nucleated. Here is the seven cells, no, 1 2 3 4 5 6, and it is nothing but a seven cell and eight nucleated structure, and a nucleated structure is called as nothing but a mature embryo sac. After that this mature embryo sac is developed with a single megaspores. Here is a diploid get haploid and one megaspore is remaining. These three get degenerated from a single megaspores. After that completion of this process there are formation of a mature embryo sac, and this stage is a nothing but is a called as monosporic development. It is a called as a monosporic. Mono means single. A single spore get developed. So it is a called as a monosporic development. Very simple word, you know. Mono, single, spore, spore. So it is a monosporic development. Only a one spore can be generated, and later on it get completed in the embryo sac. So it is a monosporic development can be completed on here. And in angiosperms, the development of female gametophyte is an endospore, that is a within the megaspores. So this total female gametophyte is a colorless endosporic and concealed, enclosed in a ovary. So actually this is a development of female gametophyte. You know the structure of, when you see the diagram of in your book, there is a diagram of development of female gametophyte. Only when you see the diagram it is get complicated, but when you study step by step it is very easy to understand. With the help of this diagram, the total structure of megasporogenesis or development of female gametophyte is easy to learn, and you can write with the help of diagram very easily. So megaspore, four haploid megaspores, a single can be here present. After that it get generated with a nucellus, or growth can be only a single can be converted in a growth form. After that there are three mitotic divisions takes place, and after a third mitotic division there are two polar nuclei, here two synergids with a egg protected, and at the chalazal end there are three antipodal cells. Later on get another nuclear fusion and there are formation of a mature embryo sac. So it is a total process of megasporogenesis. We complete here the little bit chapter, that is a megasporogenesis, microsporogenesis. After that we discuss on what is the exact pollination, and there are types of pollination, and later on we discuss some another parts of that chapter. Okay, thank you.